Purnamaste. Purnamaste. They want to bury us, but they forget that we are seeds. Yes, they forget we are seeds. Seeds. You know, if you look at the seeds, all the beautiful flowers and everything that we see, actually all this beauty, fragrance, magnificent beauty, what it needs most? It needs shit. It needs darkness. It needs deterioration, dirt. It needs even shit, you know. When we put a seed in the dirt, seed rottens in the dirt that is rotten, and it needs shit that stinks and is deteriorating. So you see, they want to bury us, but they forgot that we are seeds. Even Jesus Christ was buried for 3 days in the dark cave. But he has risen as eternal life out of that dark cave, out of tremendous suffering that was on the cross, that was in the cave after, and before so much, you know, before crucifixion, so much suffering. But he risen as eternal life out of that grave. Maybe that shit, that darkness, was the exact thing that was necessary for him to rise. And you see, seeds of flowers, beautiful plants, vegetables, without the darkness, without the dirt, without the shit, there's no flowers. There's no flowers. There's no flowers. So if we are flowers, then also maybe we need shit, because in that shit we search for the light. In the darkness we search for the light. We search to work on ourselves. We search to improve ourselves. Seed just thrown in the land, nothing happens. But inside the land, when the seed starts rottening, seeds feels the urge to live. An urge to come to life, urge to conquer that rotten shit, and then rise out of that rotten darkness. Seed just on the sun is dry, nothing is happening, just everything is as it is, nothing changes. But if you put the seed in the deep shit, seed becomes a flower. It says, I'm not this shit, I'm a seed. Conquers the unconquerable. All the shit, all the rottening and everything, you know. And then rises as the most beautiful flower of new life. And before it was just a seed. And if you would leave that seed just somewhere outside on the dry land, nothing would happen, nothing would change. But now it's a beautiful vegetable giving new life. It's a fruit tree giving origins, apples, pears. It's a flower beautifully blossoming on the light. Beautiful fragments. But a lot of shit was needed for that flower to grow. And if the flower would remain just on the sun and the dry land would remain dry, nothing would change. Same is with the people in this world. If we remain in the matrix on the dry land, we are seeds, nothing changes. We are dry. But when we are submerged into the darkness, into the shit, we search for the light, we search for life, we search for our soul. We rise out of that dark night. You know? Otherwise, we are just living our dry life. Everything is okay on the dry land. But when we are submerged in the shit and rottening and dirt, we search for heaven. We search for our soul. We search for our light. And out of that darkest night rises brightest light. We blossom. We conquer the darkness. Isn't it so? And then you see, today in the world, they want to bury the truth. Those who speak the truth. If there was not this shit happening, they would not speak the truth. If everything would be as it was 2 years ago, no one would be fighting so badly for liberation of humanity, for liberation of planet Earth, for freedom, for human rights, for freedom to breathe the fresh air, for the children. But the world is submerged into the deepest shit, you know? And out of that deepest shit rises brightest light. You see, so many people are speaking the truth. So many groups are rising to speak the truth, to fight for freedom, liberation of humanity, for health, for everything what we have taken for granted for so long. You know, for our children, they would not have to live in that shit. They would live in the flower of life, new life that would rise out of this shit. You know, out of darkness rises brightest light. There was no shit that the seeds were plunged in. No one would speak about immune system, about health, about freedom, about rights, about unity, and fight for freedom, rights, unity, love for the children. Because we are submerged in that deep shit. And as example goes, all the beautiful vegetables, all the beautiful fruit trees, all the beautiful flowers, they need shit. So maybe this world needs shit to rise as new life of love, as heaven and earth. Maybe we need hell to rise to heaven. Look at me, I'm sensitive. I'm a little child. I'm here all alone. Shit is happening in the country. My body needs healing. Out of darkness rises brightest light. I never lamented in these years, and I went through a lot. So when I lament a little bit, it's not easy. Maybe out of this shit, we rise. Children of light, my us go to forests, to hills, to Mother Nature. Go off grid. Create heaven on earth. For no one will save us. No one will do it instead of us. We will have to rise as humanity out of that shit, out of that slavery, out of that control, out of that shit. And you see people are rising. People are awakening. And governments are targeting just those people with the shit that are awakening. People who know what the shit is about. People who know what their plans is. People who predicted what they're doing now. People that fight for humanity, for freedom. They label such people as extremists, as terrorists. All I want to say is that if there was not shit, they would not rise. And truth is not bothered by lies. Truth speaks the truth and lets the lie be. But lies are bothered with the truth. Because as long as there is truth, lies cannot exist. Truth defeats lies just by being. And that's why they are removing people, accounts, taking freedom of speech away, labeling them as criminals, even prosecuting them as terrorists, because they speak of one love, of health, how to heal ourselves, of how to be human being, not a slave, because they love humanity. Same thing happened in America. They are labeled as terrorists, as criminals. Let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. Jesus Christ was persecuted by who? By the Jewish and Roman government. For what? For speaking the truth and people listening to the truth. Because the truth defeated all lies. So truth, only the truth can win. Only the truth can defeat lies. These lies are shit. And as you see, as shit stinks and rottens and wants the seeds, the children to rot in the shit, out of that shit arises brightest light. Truth. They are attacking the truth like I see in our country. Attacking the truth speakers as criminals. Why? Because they speak the truth. Truth defeats lies just by being. So lies must remove the truth. So the truth is not seen. Because only in this way lies can prevail and people can prevail. Believe the lies if they are not in contact with the truth. Truth just speaks the truth. Doesn't have to remove, destroy the lies. Lies get destroyed by the truth. Just by the presence of the truth. You know? And you know, Jesus would be on our side this times. He will get prosecuted maybe by the church, by religious institutions that propagate what feels the worst to us. You know? Out of darkness rises brightest light. It seems like Mission Impossible. It seems like darkness has won already. No. But only light can win. Darkness can never win. Just like in every movie. And in every movie, all movie has to appear that the darkness is more strong and that light cannot win. Only in this way the game, the movie and be at your interesting. And on the end, in most impossible way, when it looks like the darkness has already won, on the end, in most impossible way, something happens. Light wins. Something happens. It's impossible. You know? It looks impossible. It looks like there's no possibility. But there's only possibility for the light to win. And if you see, there's no possibility. Enough, if you put a little seed into the deep shit and darkness, no possibility. How can that little seed conquer the darkness? But it does. It rises as flower, even breaks through the concrete, which is impossible. And just that shit was needed for the flower to grow and break the concrete. So maybe this shit, it's just what is needed. Because you see, when we are in slavery, we want freedom. When we are in control, we want freedom. When we are in fear, we want love. Where we are slaves, we want freedom. Where we are in the midst of lies, we want truth. When we are slaves, we want freedom. So maybe out of all this, truth is to rise. Freedom is to rise. When we are in slavery, we fight for freedom. When we are attacked by lies, we speak the truth. When we are controlled, we speak about love. We choose love. So maybe just that what is needed, the deep shit for humanity to realize the deep shit that we are in and then see what we want, freedom, love, truth, unity, heaven on earth. So maybe more we are submerged in the shit, more we fight for the truth, more we fight for the freedom, more we fight for the love, for heaven on earth, for Mother Nature. More we are in hell, more we fight for our soul. When we are slaves and controlled, we see that we want to be free and united. When we are, our health is attacked, we know we want to be healthy. So maybe more we are submerged in the shit, more people are to speak the truth, spread the truth, spread the light, more people are to fight for the truth, fight for the freedom. More people are to choose freedom and heaven on earth and abundance and unity and human goodness. If there was no shit, no flowers would ever grow. They would remain dry seeds. So maybe this shit now is just what is needed. Because otherwise everything would remain dry as it was in third dimension. But now in the deep shit of the third and fourth dimension that we are in, slavery, control, lie, deception, force. When people are forced, people want to be free. When people are attacked with a poison, people want medicine. When people want to, when they want to take our health away, we want our health back for ourselves. When they want to take our soul away, the devils, we want our soul back. You know, we fight for our soul. So maybe just that is needed now, you know. So we rise as truth, as freedom, as love, as power. We rise as brightest light out of this darkest night. You know, everything will remain the same, but now people are awakening in that shit, just like flowers, just like seeds, popping up, opening up, just like seeds in deep shit. Otherwise, on the land, they would remain asleep. Now they are awakening in that deep shit, searching for the light, searching for heaven, fighting for heaven. Want change, freedom, unity, human rule, justice, health, truth. And they fight for it, and they want to build it. Maybe out of that slavery and control, we rise, we go to forest, we build communities. We build heaven on earth, unity, freedom, truth, love, respect, goodness. As like these governments, in the name of the pathogen that is not even, that is harmless, like this diversion, destroying our psychological, emotional, health, financial, economic, destroying our children, destroying everything, with deepest shit, with poison. Maybe when our children are attacked, we fight for our children. Maybe when we are attacked by hell, we start building heaven. So yes, we are seeds. But seeds grow in the deep shit. So they're burying us. But we are seeds. We need that shit. We need that darkness for us to pop up. And rise as angels, as flowers of life. Out of fear into love, out of guilt into freedom, out of lies into truth, out of control, force, resistance into free flow of being. So maybe this, what is happening now, is the seed. Plunged into the darkness of the hell of third dimension. So we can know what heaven is. Freedom, abundance, unity, human goodness, health, freedom, liberty. So people start fighting for it, building it, creating it. Maybe move out of that shit, break through that shit, and go back to Mother Nature. Go back. Take care of Mother Nature. I don't know. I'm here all alone in the apartment building. But I feel yes. We need heaven on earth, for this is hell. But shit and darkness is needed for flower to grow and for fruit to grow. For vegetables to grow. So deep shit, dead, deterioration, rottening is needed for new life to grow. So we are now in deep shit. To grow as new life, flowers of life that grew out of that shit. Out of hell, of slavery, control, deception, lie, force. We may rise as heaven on earth. Beautiful Mother Nature, beautiful water, free people, united people, love, truth, community, no force, no resistance, no control, everybody being as they feel, letting others be, love. Maybe we need that shit. For shit, deep shit is needed for flowers to grow. I give you my word, we are the seeds. They want to bury us. They forgot we are seeds. I give you my word. If anybody feels like want to offer a donation, support, I give my link there. I'm so grateful. So grateful I am. I don't know if this video, I feel this one will go uploading today. I couldn't upload 3 last videos. But if you offer a donation, you receive answer within you. You offering to this class. I'm just so grateful you keep the art of the word that I'm going and flowing from the heart. I give you my word. Thank you. So you see, Out of control, we want freedom. In slavery, we want freedom. In the midst of lies, we want truth. In fear, we want love. When we are sick, we want health. And we fight for it to create it. So maybe the deepest shit is needed for brightest light to rise. I know, if there was not this shit, I would not feel the urge now. That I have to run away somewhere where people love me. You know? And it seems impossible, all alone in this building, and really not in the best condition. But you know what? Looks impossible for the seed of the flower to conquer the darkness, the dirt that is submerged all alone in the darkness, rotting. And when it starts rotting, feels the urge to rise out of the darkness. And then no more just the dry seed, but flower of new life, giving new life to all, rising on the sun, blossoming on the sun. Possible for the seed to break through concrete and all the darkness and dirt, but one and only possibility. So it looks like impossible for the light to win, for heaven and earth. But impossible is the only possibility. Only light can win. When seed is plunged into the darkness, into dirt, we give some water. Start rotting, meditation, we rise as new flower of life. Before we were seed, now we are flower of life, rising on the light, giving honey a new life. Impossible is the one and only possibility for the seed that became a flower and a tree, submerged in the deepest shit, darkness, rotting there. I give you my word. Pur Namaste.